Good morning, everyone. As you all know, today we have our unit test, unit number 3. So let's first do a quick revision for unit 3 and then we can appear for the test. So I'll just give you a small presentation. Sorry for the technical glitches, there was some problem that was occurring. So just let me make the presentation. A small quick revision of unit number 3 is what we'll do. Okay, unit 3. Today we have a unit test and it's called a technical communication. So what we did in unit 2 was written communication. Here we were talking more about the oral parts. So we begin with public speaking, speeches that are made in public. There are different types of speeches that take place and the care that you need to take. So you have informative, you have entertaining public speeches, and you also have persuasive public speeches. There is a structure for public speech and there are various ways of doing it. Now, in public speaking, you need to be quite formal, need to take care. There are different methods which you can use. Every time the public speech is not going to be on the spot, so you can prepare beforehand. At certain occasions, it would be impromptu or things that begun in a very sudden manner and you are asked suddenly to give a speech. Now, few things that you should remember while doing public speaking is you should look into the occasion, you should look into the audience, etc. Next, we have group discussion. Here we are talking about group discussion as a part of the recruitment process. Right, so whenever there is recruitment going on, and group discussion has now become an inevitable part for it. Okay, screen is not visible. Am I audible now? Okay. I'll share the screen again. So I'll revise quickly. Public speaking, speeches that are made in public. Now here we don't just mean the public as in people. But we also mean people in front of whom you're going to talk with, whether it's your organization, within the organization as well. So there are three different kinds of public speaking: informative, persuasive, and entertainment. Depending on the purpose, there are various examples that are given. Let's say informative public speaking is used in case of passing on information. Persuasive, usually used by sales and marketing personnels, and entertainment or entertaining public speeches used by stand-up comedians. One of few examples that are there. There are different methods of doing the public speech. That is, you can prepare notes, you can memorize the entire speech. It could be an impromptu or it could be a manuscript. Okay, you have to write the script. Now, few things that we need to take care is how can you make your public speech better? One, you have to prepare. You have to gather information, you have to also analyze the audience, and you have to speak in accordance to the occasion that is available. Next is group discussion. When we are talking about group discussion, we're talking about group discussion as a part of the selection process. So what is the structure? How do they make you sit? How does a group discussion take place is what you have to look into. Next, you have the criteria or the rubrics on which you are judged, that is knowledge, listening skills, active participation, leadership qualities, etc. Then there are different kinds of organizational group discussion, brainstorming, nominal technique, and Delphi technique. These are the different techniques. Now, in brainstorming, you have sub techniques like storyboarding and Lotus Bloom. Fine. What are the do's and don'ts of group discussion? So the do's are do think about the topic, and if you have quite a good idea about it, you may initiate it. But if you do not have good idea, you should not initiate. Remember, you are not supposed to dump the information all at once, but you have to give few informations or you have to participate. So participate over the entire period of the group discussion, right? Then you have got presentation strategies. Presentation, not only PowerPoint, but also how you speak and present the same. So which are the different strategies? The four P's of presentation that you have to give. Plan, prepare, practice, and present. Then the six great helpers, the WH questions. Then you have the different strategies, that is chronological strategy of arranging the information, the main structure or the parts of a presentation. So which are these parts? These parts are the introduction, where you have the porch or an anecdote that begins the presentation. Then you have the main body. Now you have patterns to arrange the main body. So it could be chronological, sequential, or arranging in sequence, cause and effect, problem solution, etc. And the conclusion, where you conclude or bring the whole thing to an end. Now you have also to spare time. You also have to spare time for audience to ask questions. And how do you answer the question as a presenter? You have to use the tract technique. Then interview skills. So what are the skills that you require in the interview? Things that you have to talk about, questions, how they are answered, how you cannot separate your language and your body language. Moreover, you have to remember that communication is a two-way process. So you as a candidate are supposed to ask questions, and questions not pertaining only to salary, but you're supposed to ask pertaining to the role that you will play when you get a position or when you are hired for the particular position in the company. Then you have got negotiation skills, what we call in common as bargaining in our common terms, but this is more formal. So the structure of negotiation, the strategies, or when you come to a situation where you both agree upon, so would it be a win-win situation, win-lose situation, or a lose-lose situation? Negotiation skills, when they are formal, there are actually two types, informal and formal. Formal negotiations are a stepwise process that takes place. Then you have got creative and critical thinking in communication, how you could be creative and how you can be critical when you are communicating, not only just the thinking part, but also passing on the information part. What are the prerequisites? Your enthusiasm, your out of the thinking box attitude, your open-mindedness to even accept ideas that are quirky, and that are all what all is required when you are doing creative and critical thinking, and also you are communicating, right? So this was a quick revision of what we did in unit number 3. So now we have the test. There you go. There's a quiz link, the test link. Please remember, read the options and the questions carefully before you answer it. You know, they might be a little confusing at times. Read it once and twice. Don't be in a hurry to submit the test. Right? Good luck for the test. You may begin your test now. Excellent. 42 of you have already completed the test. That's good to see. Right, we'll wait a few more minutes and then we'll take questions that you found difficult or you made a mistake, and we'll discuss those questions. Everybody has completed the test. Congratulations on that. And I have got the question. I think there is the same confusion for everybody in the same question, right? So we'll take that first question first, which Dhruv has asked, and most of you have told me. Now, see, as I said, please remember and try to recollect what was being discussed in the class. The question that you have asked me is, which of these must be avoided in a group discussion? So there are options like, just give me a minute, speaking facts, asking questions, speaking fast, and speaking with clarity. Now I think option 1 and option 4 are quite clear. I've got the second question as well. Let me first clarify the first one, then we'll go to the second one. So here, as I said, speaking facts and speaking clarity is two options that we will eliminate immediately, and we all would be having only two options, asking questions and speaking fast. Okay. Now see, out of the two, both options seem to be correct, but most of us went with speaking fast. Okay. Yeah. Most of us went with speaking fast. Now see, speaking fast can still be tolerated. But have I ever told you to ask any question in group discussion? So why would the answer be asking questions and not speaking fast? The aim of the group discussion or the objective of the group discussion is to give your opinion on a particular topic that has been assigned to you. Yes, if you will ask a question, you will just ask your peer, classmate, or the group mate to give his or her opinion. You'll not be asking, you know, that why have you given us this topic or why this opinion you are giving. So you're never supposed to ask that. If you remember the entire presentation that we have done or the discussion we have had on group discussion, never have I asked you ever that you have to ask questions. See, I've been telling and telling every time, I have been reminding that you have to give your opinion. You have to give your opinion, and you have to support your opinion with facts and figures. Right? If you speak a little fast, it is fine in group discussion. So out of the two options that are creating a confusion, the best answer would be option 2. Yes, I understand that we are not supposed to speak fast whenever we are giving any oral communication, because we need the human mind to understand it. Now, when there are two similar looking options that we are going to learn in unit 4 as well, do not worry, making a choice. Okay, how do you make a choice? But here, out of the two given options, the better option or the nearer option to the answer would be asking questions. Because in group discussion, you are not supposed to ask questions. Say in the interview, you ask questions. Say in public speaking, you have to have space for the public to ask you questions. Even in presentation, you have space for asking questions. But group discussion, you do not have any scope or any space for asking questions. And that is why the answer. I hope I'm making myself clear. Now, I think the second question is not group discussion, it should be negotiation, Vartika, I think, which you are asking. So you're not only, you don't reach a agreement. Reaching an agreement is step 4. If you remember the steps of negotiation, it's the second last step. And the last step would be you implement what you have agreed to. Negotiation, towards the end of the negotiation, you don't come to only an agreeable point. Right? Let's say we agree on something and then do we leave it there? No. What do we do is we move one more step forward and we implement it by making a proper documentation. And that is why the answer is coming and implementing into a whatever has been agreed to. Here again, you have to look into the options which are confusing you. Yeah, I know these three questions were a little with the twist. And this is actually trying to help you prepare for the mid-semesters and prepare for the final exams in case they are MCQ exams, right? This is how confusion can be created. I know you are very well read. Most of you are doing very good work. But this is, you know, these are few of the questions which will, you know, try to play with your mind, with the words. That's what's happening. And Mahak, remember, I have been telling you always, you have been asking me the question for the usage of minimum word in presentation. Right. Why minimum? Remember, I told you, whether it is writing a letter, whether it is written or oral communication, it is meant for the audience and not for you. Now, if you have a lot of words, if you have a lot of words or a lot of pictures, the audience will be distracted. In case the audience is distracted, what will happen is the entire attention of the audience will shift from the person who is speaking to what is written. You will be busy reading what is written. That is why do we need to have minimum words? We need to have minimum words because remember, you are not reading the PPT, you are presenting it. Right? So one of the facts about presentations is it is bullet points, so many less words. The second fact is because the speaker is going to speak along with the presentation or along with the display of the slide. So minimum usage of words so that your audience retains their attention in listening to the speaker and not reading the PPT, and that's why the answer would be such. Okay, which is not a way you can impress the person you are negotiating? Just let me have a look at the question over here. Okay, Gaurav, the options that are given, so see, when you are negotiating with somebody, what are the things you will tell the person, right? It's very simple. Why? Let's say the options that are given to you are explain the type of your company, describe your competitor, introduce yourself, and explain the financial position. So option one is very obvious. When you negotiate, you'll introduce, right? We're talking about, see, negotiation, not bargaining. So if I'm bargaining with somebody, I'll say, you know, we are your regular customers. Remember, my grandmother also bought things from your place. That's an introduction. Same thing would also happen in formal negotiations, formal bargainings, right? You introduce that we belong to so-and-so company, explain the type of a company. Now, why is the answer C? The option answer over here is C. Describe your competitor. Do you, like, be very practical about it. When you are buying any stuff, do you talk about another shop that also buys it? Do you also talk about your competitor, you as a, let's say, if I'm from Marwari University and I want to wish to purchase certain services or books, do I talk about any other university when I'm negotiating? I might talk about the other company from which I can buy, but I'll not talk about the companies which are in line with me and wish to buy the same product. Right? I don't talk about them. I try to highlight my strong points, my strengths. And thus the answer would be, you don't describe your competitor, the company who's negotiating that competitor. Okay, we're not talking about the competitor from where you are buying. Right? The one who is going to buy, we don't talk about, like, let's say if you take Marwari University and we wish to negotiate something, we don't talk about Gujarat University or Saurashtra University or, let's say, Maharaja Sayaji Rao University, MS University. We'll be talking and highlighting only about Marwari University. That's why the answer would be that. So do we have any other questions or queries? I hope this is giving you a good idea and a good outlook into how MCQ questions can be formed and what kind of options can be there and, you know, how do you answer it. I hope this is helping you out with that type as well, because we're really not very sure which way the exams would be conducted, right? So we're trying to prepare in a dual way, and I hope this is helping you out with it, right? So there'll not be only straightforward questions, there'll be also application based questions. As I said, unit 2 and 3 are more application based, right? When you do it in the real scenario, we try to form questions from interview skills as well. So if you are introducing yourself, which is the best way? So there was a question which was included over here. It's trying to help you out about that practical aspect as well, right? Most of us in our lab batches, we are trying to work on it as well. We are trying to form questions and how do we answer that particular question. We are doing that work. So I hope this tests which we are having for each unit is giving you a little insight into how questions can be asked if it is MCQ, right? If I'm not. So do we have any other questions which were confusing? All clear, right? That's good. You may be able to save your test trip. I hope you are saving your unit test. You can save it by pressing Control P and it will give you an option to save the entire quiz or entire test as a PDF. Right? So if you have not been saving, you may save it for your future reference as well, like preparing for the final exams. This would be useful. Right? I might not be able to share the link every time. So what you can always do is, once you finish your test and you want to save the entire test with your responses, you may always press Control P. I know it's for printing, but it will give you an option. In Google Form, it will give you an option to save the file as a PDF, right? The dates for the mid-semester exam have not been conveyed yet. The moment it is conveyed, I or the class coordinator would be informing you and updating you. We are not yet been informed about the same. Whenever it is, do not worry. The unit says this, or the course or the syllabus as of now stays the same. If there are any changes, the moment I know, I'll be informing you guys as well, right? And do not worry, whenever the exams are scheduled for, whenever it is informed to me, I'll be informing you further. Now let's take the attendance for the day. Just give me a moment. Enrollment number 2, 5, 8, 9, 10, 12, 16, 17, 19, 24, 25, 26, 29, 31, 34, 35, 38, 44, 38 I have marked you present, 46, 7, 49, 50, 51, 53, 54, 56, 58, 57, 68, 9, 22, 23, 82, 85, 89, 91, 96, 100, 101, 102, 103, 106, 108, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 125, 126, 131, 134, and 144. I'll speak out the absent numbers so that it's easier for you and me. So absent numbers 9, Ravi Bhatt, 34, Ishan. Ishan is present. And you have 67. And then you have 134 and 144. These are the absent numbers for today. So with this, we have completed 50% of our syllabus along with the tests and all. We are now tomorrow, with tomorrow's lecture, we're going to start with unit number 4. I hope all the three batches would be, all the three would be ready with group discussion. I'm giving a reminder today, we are going to do group discussion in the lab sessions from tomorrow onwards. And to answer your question, Gaurav, I am really not sure when the college is reopening. We're going to work according to the guidelines given by the government and UGC. So as of now, there are no there's no such information about the opening of colleges. We've not received any instructions from UGC or the government as of now, right? So don't worry. We'd be happy to see you on the campus. So the way you are missing the campus, we are also missing the students in our campus. So don't worry. Whenever we come to know, we'll inform you surely about it. Fine. So tomorrow we'll start with unit number 4. And for the lab sessions, this is a reminder. We are going to do group discussion only. Topics have been assigned to you. Please start working on the same if you have not worked on it. Fine. Thank you, class. Have a nice day.